The purpose of that presentation to a little bit introduce you the new initiative around analysis of the fine art with involvement of innovation technologies. I will talk about a little bit about the main idea of mobile analytical lab, and we'll particularly we'll talk about some technology which we are planning to incorporate to that project. In particular, we'll talk about acoustical and ultrasound imaging technology, infrared, near infrared, short infrared, thermographic technology is a big package which are extremely developed during recent time. Few words about classic X-ray, ultraviolet, but just in conjunction with a new mathematical method which help us to make it much more efficient. Raman and X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy, also from the point of view of mobility and new software support. The variant I will show about Crekelio and thread tracing technique is mostly related to software, new software affiliated with signal and image processing. And at the very end, we'll provide you some examples of our recent field trip here in the United Kingdom, in Cambridge, Norfolk, and also in Moscow and Pushkin Museum. So, once again, a few words about mobile analytical lab. What we expect to have, what our mission to be there. It's so, the idea to put all together a portable imaging equipment which will help to serve easy analysis of art object on the field. And we will talk about some technology which just came from another area, from engineering, from physics. Some of the technology came from defense sector. It's really advanced, innovative technology which can really help a lot with analysis of art object. What is a huge, very significant advantage of mobility lab? You don't need to bring art object to the analytical lab. Analytical lab come to you, whatever you will be. It can serve in principle, provide worldwide service in the future. It's our vision, our concept, and we will try to achieve this goal as soon as we can. It will be very confidential work by definition because we work with a private gallery, with private collector, with the banks, with insurance company. So it's by definition will be like that, and we will present the whole necessary reports in each particular case. Now the kind of logo of our activity, its picture is worth a thousand words because major activity for us is imaging. And we'll start with ultrasonic and air coupling acoustic imaging as a first example, and it's particularly developed by our group. I'm proud that we developed this. We have one PhD student who defends in that field, and a couple students are working on that, and it's already a very significant result was achieved, and I will show you a few of them. So it's a pretty well work for frescoes, for painting and canvas, and for wood painting. It doesn't work for three-dimensional images like sculptures, whatever, but because in principle it can work, but it will be much more expensive, much more bulky. For flat object, it's a perfectly fit, and it's not touchable because it's about inch distance between transducer and the object under investigation, and you can choose different kind of resolution in frequency. You see it can be four times different, depends on your goal. It's from like half millimeter resolution up to 5 millimeter resolutions. And so I will show you how it's, just push it a little bit, how it's work, what is the problem we have. So how wooden painting, they consist from wood, from glue, from ground, and from painting by themselves. And after that, when you put you on the wall, the temperature changes, the humidity changes, and it's from year to year, from dozen years, 100 years, and of course it's breeding, and because it's breeding, it began to be some color defect, different defect. I just show you a simple defect, the delamination between growing ground, but it can be some cracks in ground, in painting, it's cartilage, and wood, you know, wood can, some animals start to live in wood, to get to eat it, so it's a lot of defects. So painting need to be restored time to time, and need to be very carefully very carefully examined from time to time as well. And this is example of painting, 400 years old painting on the wood. It's from Flemish painting, some citizen from Amsterdam. And you know, the curve of that, it's almost like icon. The wood, you see curved, here it's 2.6 millimeters, here 6.7, so it's thick and curved. And visually, if you restore it, I bring it, brought it to you and asked to help, you see in that area a lot of bubbles. So you say, okay, I see this, we'll fix it. You'll fix it, give it back to conservator or private collector. And after a few months later, or half a year later, it will be more here. You can say, oh, you don't know what you are doing, but person can do it. If you give it to X-ray, X-ray doesn't show you anything. That. So it's very good to know what, where is your real damage, not only visually, but maybe it's below the surface, which you cannot penetrate by your eyes. So for that reason, we use this non-contact air coupling method. And you can see on that slide, it's a single side scan using 200 kilohertz transducer. So for you, and for me, it's nothing to mean. So you need to process this image. You need to analyze this image. And for that reason, what was developed our original algorithm. And condition it?
Oh. Yes, please.
And now you can see the result of that processing. It's binary image. And black one is damage area. Now you can see, yeah, you see physically that part, visually on that, but you don't see this part, you don't see this part, you don't see this part. So if I'm museum conservator or curator, and I give it my job to restore that, that map I can give it. This is my text pack. I can tell him, you need to fix all that stuff here, not only that original part, which you see visually, but also that part. In that case, I'm sure that my painting will be properly restored. This is giving a lot of effort and from time point of view, from my point of view, to help properly to restore, to rebuild the painting. So, you want to go? Вы хотели куда-то отойти?
Нет, я не хотел отойти, просто у нас камера с этой стороны стоит, поэтому вот на камеру надо просто немножко.
О, и может не с той стороны встать?
Нет, 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 никаких проблем, просто...
То есть нужно немножко туда смотреть, да?
Ну да, и один момент.
Спасибо.
Извините, просто не, не, записываю, не. Поэтому...
Ага, хорошо. Ну, или мне с той стороны встать?
Как вам удобно?
Я могу поменяться потом.
Давайте. Как вы скажете, давайте поменяться. Вообще у нас настроена она была сюда.
А, окей.
Поэтому все как лучше, лучше здесь.
Все как вы скажете. Now, from that kind of low frequency, low resolution part, like when we talk about millimeters, let's move to the high resolution and acoustic microscopy. This is really for tiny stuff. It's a lot of interesting application. And again, we, thanks God, or thanks to ourselves, we are experts in that area. That microscope was built by ourselves. And resolution can be really very high. We can see up to 0.5 millimeters up to 5 microns, so really tiny resolution. And it's portable device, we especially developed this, next slide please, device for material characterization. It's a good example of, as I said, technology transfer. So it was developed for aerospace, for aircraft industry, for automotive industry, and for that reason it was microscope which you can put some sample here, but also there is a handheld device which allow you to put, let's say, on the painting, on the deep panel, which you cannot cut, like a part of the missile, part of the plane, and you can see that object right away by handling. So, next slide. And I will show you a few applications, a few examples. First of all, this is just to understand unique result you can receive here. This is just normal euro coin, 20 cents, and we can see back image through the metal. So, for example, this is coin I twisted for 180 degrees, and I can see that image through the metal. So, and you can, as you can see, the sky resolution. Next slide, please. Can you stop? Just, yeah. This is a panel from composite materials which was developed for Boeing Dreamliner. We were involved in that project from beginning, and because you know the fuselage of Dreamliner for 75% built from composite materials, it's crucial to know how reliable and good materials. And first of our investigation was to see what kind of defect. So this is a sample with small defect. Here you can see defect is about half a millimeter on the surface, and we need to investigate this. How do we investigate this defect? We began to scan the area line by line, and as a result, we can have the image. Next slide. And if you will see, this is the surface, and we began to move, and you see this is what small dent, and this is inside something wrong. It's image. We collected during half a minute about 267 slides. 267 slides alone. And after that, but if you ask me what I can see, even me, who is like expert in ultrasound, I cannot say. I see some wrong stuff here. For that reason, we need to process this. And this next slide show how we began to work with that three-dimensional database. And it's kind of very complicated mathematics based on Hilbert transformation and special proprietary algorithm. We build this, and after that we demonstrate the results. Next slide, please. And next slide, it will be, I will eliminate, yeah. You will see that it's a kind of spiral, very complicated defect. Each yellow island, this is delamination. So I don't recommend you and don't want to fly on the airplane with such kind of defect. Here 3 millimeters, here 3 centimeters. So it's a huge empty cavern inside the composite materials. But I can, it's a negative part. Positive, I can say that this is one of the first generations of composite materials. It's a result of 3 years old. Now they have perfect materials. So welcome to flight on board Dreamliner. Next slide, please. Same technology, same idea was used for painting, and this is a piece of the some fragment of the painting, and this is three-dimensional image. You can see here reflection from the delamination, reflection from the painting surface. So it's a lot of tiny defects. You can see this very high resolution. Next slide, please. Portable ultrasound can be used also for bronze, for sculptures. This is a huge benefit for them, and this is a sculpture of French sculptor, early 19th century sculpture, and you know, right now, even question of the forgery, for example, it can be built, produced in China, or even Italy right now try to do the same stuff. So how you can separate forgery from the real stuff. This is a kind of a few recipes of that. When they fabricate this at that time, they put some seal, some stamp on the soft metal when it was still hot. And that sealing a very important part of reality. And can you show next slide? And using ultrasound, we can easy to say even stamped in the solid metal, or it was like a coin which was just pushed in the metal. And if it pushed in the metal, there is an interface, and I can easily recognize that. So by ultrasound. It's 2 minutes for me, and I will tell you this is real stem or it's a fake stem. Second one, at that time technology was not so well developed like today, and when they build this, they will produce this, they have some subsurface hollow and bubbles inside the copper, inside the bronze, sorry. And this hollow remind you since the time of the sculpture fabrication was molten, and this is what kind of another proof that defect proved that it was real. So we can see these bubbles on the chest of that nice young lady, and this show that it's really old sculpture, because today it's very difficult to generate that bubbles. It was naturally done because the technology was not possible to develop. It's just a couple of examples how ultrasound can help easier on the field. Next slide, please. And of course, very interesting, another test to show it's like, you know, there is a patina. On the old bronze, there is a patina. And patina, you can also, we take a, we investigate just the end here, her nose, using Raman spectroscopy, and there is a specific characteristic where is a kind of passport for the patina, which was, you can compare it with the patina of the another standard sculpture which you have in Louvre, for example, in some private collection, which you know in particular it's original. So you can compare and say, yeah, that's patina. It's additional argument to show that is a real painting. Just another example from another lot investigation of patina and corrosion for Salvador Dali painting. Next one. So now let's move to the infrared and shortwave infrared technology. So from ultrasound to infrared, to infrared thermographic imaging. Next, please. So we use an advanced technique from very simple technique, which was recently began to be on the market for infrared imaging, forensic, mostly for forensic stuff. And that camera, which came from research military labs for night vision system. Next slide, please. And I will show you how that camera easy can help with evaluation, with the nation of painting. This is example, it was a study project. This is a 8 years old painting, which was intentionally altered. So it's already something altered there. We don't know how it was altered, but it was given to us, and they asked us to find where it was done some forgery stuff, an alteration. Look, first, visually I can say that something wrong with that, because the signature here is my name here, Roman Mayev. I didn't do this. I will be proud, but not. Next one. Using even first step in new infrared study, you can see, for example, that in that area, whole chapel was covered. So there is a chapel here, and we don't see it here on that painting. Also, the attic window on the roof of the building was canceled. So you see that attic here. And also, the chimney was moved, and the roof had a different angle. You can see it here as well. So, next slide, please. And again, if you come back to my signature, infrared very clear show that patch. And even on ultraviolet, you can see, but not so obvious. But here it's obvious, something wrong here. And he very professionally did it, believe me. But there is another more prestigious goal, to try to find original signature behind mine. And near not allow you to do this, but the most advanced developed pulse wave thermography imaging allow you to see the image, the signature of the original author. And this is, it's really great, because it's allow you to move to the, to penetrate with a specific requested depth of penetration. So I want to move, let's say 100 micron, I can move 100 micron, I can move 200 micron, I can move 200. So it's like a slight salami to do it. So it's very important stuff. This is just a demonstration, it's a short wave infrared imaging, it's a new technology on the market, and just to demonstrate you how good quality of the image. You see, this is visual, and this is, you see the high contrast, you have the high resolution, it's very bright, easy to analyze, and it's an additional to visual stuff, and very important. I will show you later on some results. Next slide, please. With that technique, you can discover a lot of interesting stuff, and this is one of our discoveries which I would like to share with you. It's a painting of Austro-Hungarian author under Dudits. It's a painting in the Budapest Museum. The name is Annunciation. It's just like pre-Christian. It's the three walls sitting here and think about new coming holy man to the earth. And when we began to investigate the painting, we discovered something strange on the other side of the lake, on the beach of the lake. Can you next slide, please? And here we prepare kind of a movie which demonstrates how we move from normal vision to infrared image. And when we move to infrared image, you begin to see the village or city on the other side of the lake. It's kind of sketch here. You see, it's nothing here, and it's obviously it's a big city, big village on the other side of the lake. But also, he changed also some configuration of the tree. He different shape before painting completed. So you see, it's some different stuff. And also, there is a strange figure in the between trees. With Maria Magdalena or whatever, I don't know, but you can only guess this figure. So it was very serious changes in the painting during that stuff. And now we can come to that 100 years older and to see the secret of his academical laboratory inside. So it's kind of amazing stuff. You can fly back to the old ages. About thermographic, a few examples about thermography imaging. We use for that very sensitive device. It's also a typical example of technology transfer. This is state-of-the-art device from thermimaging. It's so secretly developed that we cannot bring it even to the United Kingdom. I don't ask about Russia, it's impossible, but that allow us to bring it to the United Kingdom. Only North America we can use it. Very sensitive and very high frame rate ability, 350. And very simple to work with that. So I put camera, I put some small flash lamp, and can shoot this image, and I have the image. Can you show the next slide, please? And I don't want to bother you with the details, but the main stuff what I would like to say that because it's 350 up to 350 rates, I can have this very high time resolution imaging, and if I know how deep this, it's again as I said with slide salami, I can go from the surface to subsurface, deeper, and I can see any details. It depends on the ability of the device, ability of the object, and of course experience of the operator. But we'll show you a couple examples. For example, next one. It was easy to recognize. X-ray doesn't show it. You see on here thermal imaging, we can see cross as additional stuff with the chain, but for some reason it was eliminated in the old version. But most amazing result, which you are really proud of. The next slide. That painting was under our investigation. We think it's a Rubens school, or maybe it's even Rubens, because there is a Rijksmuseum painting, there is a painting in Hermitage, and that painting, which under our investigation right now, you can see even a little bit more dramatic than even Rijksmuseum painting, because here they sit both of them on the bench, it's a little bit more comfortable sitting. Can you come back? Let's jump here. No baby here, all breasts is open, so it's a little bit more, how to say, erotically, more theatralic painting. This is more dramatic. He sits on the seventh floor, and there is a baby, so you understand why she gave him a breast. And the second breast is covered next like this. And when we, this is what our painting, let's say, and this is painting from Christ Museum. And one of the art historians asked us, listen, it's interesting to see, is it was originally like that or maybe it was not? And only thermal imaging led us possibility to see that originally, on the first drawing, the breast was open. And after that, they cover this. So it's, I don't see any other method in the world who can provide such kind of tiny investigation. And it's very, very interesting and important. So, next slide, please. And of course, we use a Raman spectroscopy very broadly. We use we have a good equipment, lab equipment at the university. I have very one of the best in the world, famous in the world colleague working with it, Dr. Aroka. He has maybe 5-6 monographs. But we modified the system for portable use and. And for that reason, we use a very small portable devices which allow you to give access directly to the painting. Next slide. So you can see how it's worked. So art historian or art expert give you, I want to see Raman spectroscopy of your limbs, I want to see Raman spectroscopy of your white dress, red dress, whatever. And right away we do it, and actually right now we're talking, it's another our project, talking with a smart drive company to build a scanner system which automatically can give you all that access, and we can do it not in the lab. Again, I can come to the National Gallery, I can go to the British Museum, I can go to any place and do it just in the place, just in the hall. Just I need to put a few partitions to cover, not to confuse the visitors. Next slide, please. It's just another example, show how it's portable and easy system, so you just choose me whatever place I need to, spot I need to investigate, and I will have exact information right away. Next slide, please. And the same portable system work for fluorescent spectroscopy. It's a very sensitive, very important method, and you can see we didn't change too much here compared with other methods. It's a Brooklyn technology, well developed, and give us fantastic results right away on the field as well. Yeah. So, for example, again, we need to see some details from that area, from that area, and we can see red, white, and very long spectrum from that painting, from that pigment, and then from other pigments. So, easy access and very efficient. Next slide, please. Now I would like to talk about our expertise in fingerprint in image processing. Next slide, please. And using X-ray technique. So the idea that X-ray technique is one of the oldest techniques which was used by art experts. And we brought the idea that we can process the image which already exists your museum and give you unique result which you never had before. Please, next slide. So, in particular, we can evaluate thread enhancement and thread orientation and density of the thread right away. So, why it's important? Because again, it's a fighting with surgery, and again, and it's a evaluation of the health of your painting. Because we take your, this is just an example of horizontal and vertical thread. Next slide, please, we'll show you maybe this example. This is the original image. And after that, what we do, we have X-ray image. And that image you have in each museum. I can come, I just need relatively high quality, not upper quality, but normal quality of the image. And after that, I process them. This is thread density map. Horizontal density, it's kind of already signature of that particular canvas, and after that I do X-ray image with trace thread. So I filtrate that image. I take out the image of Cardinal Mazarini. I take out all that stuff. I just only collect the thread traces. And after that, if I need to see some details, here is a fragment of that. I can see fragment detail. I can see how it's curved and what happens. If, for example, you decide to cut half of the painting and put it on the new frame, thread will be completely different. And I can see, oh, something happens. You did something with that painting. So it's very important information which can help to monitor the history of the painting and condition of painting. Next slide, please. Let's talk about graphic regulation. Here, I'm proud to say that here a few world name experts in Kreckler, so I don't want to explain too much about it. But Kreckler, it's a baby of long life of painting, usually. You know, this is kind of like idea that about structure of the painting. I already talked to you about that at the very beginning of my presentation. But it's again, there is a different kind of cracks which can happen. Expert in that area, they split it for drying age and brittle ages and mechanical is obvious. And so when you have a good painting like we have here on the wall, they have a cracking, which means that it's a real good quality painting. But so we try to investigate geographical region of the painting and also health monitoring of the system. And here I provide one example. This original image of the cracker. Now we process them and subtract two images in one, and after that threshold the image. We threshold them, and after that I need to digitize it because it's a mess of something. To digitize, I put all coordinates and all that stuff and do crack network. So I put all that points, remember it's a huge memory database. And I collect them in the frame of some additional line size, density, number of nodes, number of edges, point and judge points. And after that, I narrow them for. And after that, I can tell you with some probability to which region belong that painting. For example, 60% is Flemish, and a little bit French, it's a little bit more Italian. So it's for sure Flemish painting. So it's easy to do, but it's not only one application or not important application. Important application is a healthcare. For example, this crack image 2002, this is 2005. I compare the same fragment and I can see, oops, I have new crack which happened. So it's a very simple example, but it's very important itself for healthcare, and it's cheap stuff compared with other what people are doing right now. And most important, I didn't mention it here, and I want to mention because we are very serious to work on that, it's our kind of confidential, to make a signature of the painting. So our target to come to the big museum said, how many treasure painting you have? 150, so we make a signature for you. And you have fingerprint of all these 150 paintings, you will have to keep them in your safe place, and you know for sure that it's safe, and nobody can broken that, and it's for sure, it's like in the good bank. Scottish Royal Bank, for example. Next one. This is another example. It's already from Pushkin Museum. It's amazing result from Branzina, Madonna and Child. You can see here Jesus Christ and John Baptist. And it was some changes done in composition, and it's interesting to see how painter did it at his time. So you can see the Jesus hand was moved from original stuff, and it's easy to see here. You see, it's amazing technology which allow you to see it was moved. There also John Baptist hands also was moved, so they changed slightly all composition, and it's interesting to go to that like 400 years on the earlier and to try to understand his vision. So he made her Maria Magdalena hands much more elegant. That it was at the beginning, he reconfigured her finger. And also he changed a little bit Jesus' leg. So we can see, we can move 400 years in deep on the on 14th century and see what was his secrets there at that time, what was his thought about this. It's another example, I can give you another example from also from Pushkin Museum, from Jacob Jordan's. He was a student of Rubens, and after that became a very famous painter as well. It's from Pushkin Museum collection. It's also infrared reflectography, different composition of that painting. See the difference between this image and our infrared. First of all, we can see that it was cropped. Second, we can see that the dog face here. Some part of the table, you see it here, it's nothing here. Also, very interesting composition of the people sitting on the desk. The guy sits with the hair, but after that he take out his the head and put some additional face here. So it's additional information which give you a little bit additional spirit of the history of the painting. Next slide. Yeah, you just move like boom, boom, boom. That was done with Fitzwilliam's Museum. It's completely different application. That seven panel was built in wood. They said maybe they do from the same piece of wood or not. So the technique is as well. It's like a play with puzzles. It's a big fun as well. Like to do this. We investigated the quality of the wood and we see, okay, that three panels look like they're from the same part. And then another three panels, they have additional combined support. So it's also maybe done. And only one guy, he's kind of a single. He cannot fit with that three and that three. So it's the guys from Fitzgerald Museum was so happy to and we did it during 3 hours, though all that result was done. That amazing result suddenly happens, we didn't expect it. It's also from Pushkin Museum, and using infrared you can see some defect, but no, it's not the main excitement. The main excitement, you can see face of the guy and the body of the girl. So it can be two answers in principle. It can be how painter make use old painting, or it can be, for example, typical forgery. It was famous painting, and it was covered by some cheap stuff, and how you can eliminate painting from one country to another. But that not particular case. That case is museum case, as it was from the same painter. But in principle, it's possible to do this. And the next one. That was done with Dr. Buklov, who is sitting here in Norfolk, Church of St. Marie, and we evaluate wooden panels, and you see there are some panels with a nice painting and some panels is completely empty. This is St. Cecilian, it's amazingly nice looking painting, and empty panel which was covered by fake wood. So we spent almost a day here to try different technology. We were really was stressing because we couldn't see. But finally we discovered one panel. You can see the face of the Christian apostle here with his dress, with everything. And it's one of the Catholic saints. And another one, it's a female with nice hair, with knee here and a nice dress. So I hope it will be processed very soon by professional restorer and we'll see nice painting in there. So that was result was done 2-3 months ago. Thank you very much. That's it. It's our team. It's like one guy, two guys from here was in Cambridge in May, June, but the rest is just a physicist working with me. Thank you very much. And, yeah.